Okay, and welcome back to another edition of Casual Conversations. I have the pleasure to be sitting here with Dr. McCune. Dr. McCune, how are you today?
I'm fantastic. Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too. Finally, we are here. You are super, super busy, so we're not going to take too much of your time. The first question I always ask every single doctor that I meet is, what first interested you in becoming a doctor?
My dad was a physician, so growing up he was a gastroenterologist, so I had a lot of exposure to the hospital, to his office, and those kind of things. Growing up I was one of his secretaries in accounting and did those kind of things around his office and had a lot of exposure to different procedures he would do. Became interested that way.
What kind of doctor was he?
Gastroenterologist.
Gastroenterologist. So did you think that kind of like led you into the work that you're doing in some type of way, or did it just seeing your dad go to work every single day, that was just kind of enough for you?
It definitely laid the groundwork for me to be interested in medicine. Mm-hmm. My mom was a nurse, so it was a very common topic of conversation around the dinner table. When I was in college, I originally wanted to be a journalist, but I excelled in the sciences and ended up kind of gravitating towards medicine because of different personal things and family commitments. And then I ended up being a physician.
That's amazing. I always talk to people about the intersections with medicine, right? We always think that it's kind of siloed over here and that there's no connection to anything else. But it really is actually connected to journalism. It's connected to education. It's connected in so many different capacities. Do you see that in your work today, or do you think that it is siloed a little bit?
I see that more now than I did when I was in my training. I think when we're in training, we have so much bandwidth dedicated to medicine to be able to learn a new language and learn different procedures and really gain a whole new skill set, that we do become a little bit siloed. It's really hard to read. It's really hard to appreciate the news the way you should and participate in politics.
Mm-hmm.
So, since I've become an attending and live in New York, it's much easier to reintegrate into the rest of society.
Yeah. But as soon as you step outside of the hospital,
yeah,
something
takes,
going on.
Like, yeah, it takes not work, like kind of being here and being done with my training.
Now, where did you go to medical school?
I went to medical school in Indiana University.
So very different from New York.
Yeah, I've only been here 4 years.
Okay. Have you adjusted
years.
A little bit?
I have now. My first year here was quite a bit of an adjustment, mm-hmm. but since then I would have a really hard time.
No cars.
Yeah, no cars.
Do you think that looking back, I guess, at the beginning of your trajectory in medicine and starting to practice and just evolving. Would you ever believed or imagined that you would be here right now?
Oh, not at all. Well, we talked about this a little before. I was a teenage mother, and so I think my family kind of expected me to more likely be in jail than attending at Columbia. I'm just kind of teasing, but like, so this for everybody was a little bit of a shock.
Really? Mm-hmm. So I guess that you just kind of pushed through it.
I had a lot of support.
Okay.
I had a lot of family support.
Okay.
Everybody kind of got me here.
That's amazing. Well, I mean, it's great to have a family that supports you to kind of see you shine now. So, Dr.
Absolutely.
McCune, thank
yeah.
you very much.
Thank you.